So lots of attributes, skills, traits, character, whatever you want to call them, lots of those things go into making a really, really good leader. But like Mike and Jeffrey, I've been told to focus on just one thing. So here's my hot tip. If you can't laugh at yourself, you cannot be a good leader. Huh. So why, I mean, by laugh, by the way, I should tell you, I don't mean some weak, feigned attempt at laughter. I mean, you've really got to laugh. You've really got to see and genuinely appreciate the humor in something at your own expense. So why is that my leadership tip? Why all the things one could think about, why would it be that? Well, there are two reasons. One is that it's novel. It may be new to you. It's probably something you haven't thought about before. And two, and more importantly, it works. So before getting to this main point of if you can't laugh at yourself, you can't be a good leader, let's talk about the sort of general connection between laughter and leadership. So here's my first slide. Victor Borge. Anybody know who he was? Yeah, the old people. Yeah. He's long dead. Concert pianist and one of the funniest people who ever lived, and he said laughter is the shortest distance between two people. And then this one from Eisenhower, sense of humor is part of the art of leadership, of getting along with people, of getting things done. Eisenhower, 5-star general, president of the United States. So what's the connection here? What's all that about? It's connectivity. Humor is one heck of a good way to connect with people. Case point one. A couple of other quotes. No mind is thoroughly well organized that is deficient in a sense of humor. Samuel Taylor Coleridge, poet and philosopher. And then this one, I really like this one. A sense of humor always withers in the presence of messianic delusion, like justice and truth in front of patriotic passion. That's Henry Louis Mencken. He was a humorist and journalist. So I'm losing my place here. So what are Coleridge and Mencken saying? Common sense and a sense of humor go hand in hand. They do. They reinforce each other. Common sense is the stuff of leadership. Without it, without common sense, without a level head, you're not going to see the world around you accurately. You will misinterpret. You will make poor decisions. Now, of course, there are caveats in all of this. Don't ever make fun of anyone is one of them. I mean, it's just really a stupid thing to do. And you know, you're burning bridges when you do that. So just don't do that. Here's a quote from a really great guy. Laughter at someone else's expense turns weak comedy into small tragedy. Edward Foster Brooks. Somebody. Also, you know, we know that laughter or humor doesn't work in every situation. I mean, there are lots of times when humor is totally, totally out of place. So all of that. So what's all this about so far? Well, it's to get me back to my main point. If you can't laugh at yourself, you can't be a good leader. When the joke's on you, you can't laugh at yourself, and you're not another one in a million like Steve Jobs, who, by the way, could laugh at himself, you aren't likely to be a good leader. Why? You take yourself too seriously. You might be overly concerned with your image. You may not take criticism well. You may be afraid of failure. And finally, your knee-jerk reaction may well be to blame someone else for your embarrassment. I'm guilty of that one once in a while. So if you are these things, you won't earn people's respect. You just won't. And respect is essential to leadership because authority is delegated upward, not downward. I've said this in class, right? Upward, not downward. Leaders lead because their followers, their employees, their team, fellow team members allow them to lead. That is a truth that applies even to the strongest of dictators. It may take time, but if you don't want to wind up like Gaddafi, laugh at yourself once in a while.